Okay, so before I start, it's another question I just want to dwindle on this for a couple seconds. How many of you guys have had a person in your life that has changed your life significantly to the point where if they were not involved in anything that you were doing, you would have been in a completely different situation? Now, before I show you guys,
yeah, towards the window, the front. It goes like. Are you on the computer? No, you're under there, right?
Yeah.
Do you see on the front? You just slide up in the front.
It's the other side of the thing.
To the left of the
thing.
I just keep doing this. I don't know why that wasn't. Focus. I'm sorry. Yeah. No, not on there, hon. Oh, yeah, on there. All right. There. Good. She's great. There you go. There she is.
Okay. So before I mention anything,
I'll
just kind of update you guys on what's going on with me. So I do look a mess. Sorry. In this picture, this is my grandma who passed away 2 months ago. And I was just coming back from, not swim practice, I'm sorry. I was coming back from a swim clinic at Stanford. And when I first started swimming, this was actually the year I started swimming, 2012 into 2013.
Mm-hmm.
I did not understand it at all because there was nobody in that sport that looked like me.
Mm-hmm.
My coaches did not look like me. They didn't know how to talk to me. They didn't know how to coach me the way that you would coach an African-American female in this sport. So they tried to do their best to push me in to what they thought I should be instead of asking me how comfortable I felt with the situation.
Mm-hmm.
My grandmother became my number one fan. She became my fan club leader. She became my support system. She became my rock. She became the person that I relied on through thick and thin. And this is also this her sweatshirt. We use this phrase, I will be with you through thick and thin, just like a Lakers fan. I don't know what that means. I will talk about two things during this speech. I will talk about one, how she encouraged me to keep going and follow my dreams, and I will also talk about how she became my support system and my number one fan. First, I will talk about how she encouraged me to continue on the swim in order for y'all to get a better understanding how much this particular photo means to me. So, my first swim practice, I did not really want to do it because, for one, of course, there was nobody who looked like me in that sport or in this sport. And I was really nervous because swim does take like a lot out of you. Like, you guys get really exhausted. We probably do more than kicks than soccer players, more turns than gymnastic people. We do a lot. So she kind of was the force that kept me going to practices. She was the person who was at my swim meets, sharing the bleachers. She was the person that was behind my blocks before they did the little shotgun thing to send us off. She was the only person that you can hear cheering. Like, if you're in the pool and you're swimming, you cannot hear anything. Yeah, you can hear her. She was really loud. Secondly, I will talk about how she became my number one fan. When she found out that I was not comfortable in the sport of swim, she sat me down one day and she tried to get a better understanding of why I was feeling the way I was feeling. The number one thing that I'll always remember her telling me was that it doesn't matter how other people view you. It doesn't matter what other people say. All that matters is what you think of yourself. So from that day on, I not only grasped a better understanding and a better sense of awareness of how I moved through life, I gained a sense of pride in what I was doing. I hope that y'all were able to understand how much this particular photo means to me, and I hope that y'all were able to understand how having somebody in your life can truly change the trajectory of your path.